Going in, I knew it was going to be fun. I mean, we're coming to the Bahamas for school. That's amazing. It challenged us. It made us realize that we are capable of bigger things.
We're here in San Salvador Island in the Bahamas, the easternmost island in the Bahamian archipelago.
It's not connected with the main Bahamian platform. So when sea level rises and falls, this island records it very well.
We're investigating not only the modern coral reefs, but the theme of this course is to compare and contrast the modern coral reef to these beautifully preserved fossil coral reefs that are present on this island.
We are studying all kinds of cave systems, as well as a little bit of biology and oceanography.
This is Lighthouse Cave.
This is epic.
Our job when we get in there not only is to swim around and have fun exploring the cave, but to identify what formation we're in.
Whoa. Came to this part where it was just like, everyone had to be on their hands and their stomach.
There towards the end, every one of them really pushed their boundaries.
It was honestly one of the coolest things I've ever done. It really helped that we had this huge support system going down a line of students and faculty.
I liked how everyone was laughing, like even when we were uncomfortable.
We're staying at the Gerace Research Centre over on the north end of the island. It is part of the University of the Bahamas system. So we have a full cafeteria, all our food is provided for. We have vehicles to carry us everywhere.
Even when we're not like actively in the field looking at rocks, we're out on the truck, looking at the island in the wind, experiencing all the elements.
Cheers.
We're gonna look for stony coral tissue loss disease. I'm holding a transect tape. Tommy is studying the health condition of the reef.
Ready?
Ready. There's a good sample size here. We got a lot of video data, so I think it's a good start.
This is my first time seeing like coral reefs in person, so it's a really huge deal.
It was kind of disappointing to see that a lot of the corals were kind of dead, overtaken by algae.
The heartbreaking aspect of it is the students are seeing firsthand how some of the coral reefs here have been impacted by all kinds of environmental stressors.
I think it's really cool and really important to like preserve our like amazing world for the next few generations.
Archaeologically, this is very, very likely the spot that Columbus made landfall.
Today, we're walking around the slave plantation. We have Janet here to guide us.
This was a plantation. This is where they took their cattle to get water and persons swim in it as well.
It's a big cultural aspect of the island, and it's important for us to understand the history, kind of where the people came from.
I think it's really important to learn about culture so that history doesn't repeat itself.
You can slice it, you can see the layers where it's grown.
The more quiet you are, the better experience it is for the bats.
Watch your heads.
What you are crawling through right now is the edge of the freshwater lens and how it dissolved through this particular section.
Right now we're in Alter Cave. We're observing the bats in their natural environment and listening to them kind of click and make their noises because they can't see. I'm like, kind of want to cry. Like, it's really cool.
Their boundaries are being pushed as to what they've experienced in their normal daily lives, and we're showing them some new experiences. And one of the natural ways to react to that is to get emotional.
That's exactly what we're hoping for with this experiential learning that you can't necessarily get when you're sitting in San Diego reading a paper about coral reefs.
Well, we had it planned to go snorkeling in Pigeon Creek. When we swam it in January, it was shallow, but it wasn't that shallow. We got out there with the students and it just kept getting shallower and shallower and shallower. And then when we tried to walk, we sunk into quicksand.
Like, how are we gonna get out of here? Some people are so up ahead, crawling through mud.
Some of the students were laughing really hard, so that helped a little to lighten it.
I watched Dr. Gray beached on the seagrass going, this is awful, this is awful. I would never have that with any of my professors if we didn't do all of these amazing trips.
Their excitement is what makes learning more interesting and more fun because the passion comes through them.
They are encouraging like curiosity, learning for yourself.
I didn't have a dull moment on this trip. Like, I felt like the whole trip was special.
This is so fun.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Gloria. Gloria, awesome. It's been really gratifying to see the spark that has been ignited within the students.
This trip was like really, really special to me.
That deep emotional reaction, I think, will spur many of them to action, will motivate many of them to continue their studies.